So I thought I'd probably, whoops. Oh, I see what I did there. Haha. Don't mind me. Anyways, I thought I'd do a quick video here. I don't really have much to say, so it's going to be a pretty short video. But I thought I'd touch base because I haven't done one for a while. You're not missing anything. There's really not been, we're kind of doing the same thing that we've been doing, which is just trying to get our bees proper weight. That's the biggest thing, because I mean, we've been really aggressive with the mite treatments. We're done with those for right now. And so really the big thing to look for, hornets and wasps are horrible. But once again, if your colony is strong, you shouldn't have any problems with it. I mean, there'll definitely be some stress that comes about as a result of them having hornets and wasps around, but they should be able to take care of themselves if your colony is in good health. I've got these wasps landing on me here, and it's a pain in the butt. But anyways, so if you, just for the heck of it though, here, if we want to take a quick look at our nuke that we've been following through the year, they're all wrapped up and ready for wintering. As you can see here, they're looking healthy. They're also not too thrilled to have me breaking into their hive here in this kind of weather. Here's the split that we did. They're looking really good. I'm going to walk away here before I get stung in the face. Aha! I was quicker than he was. Tried to get me in the ear. But anyways, I've got his guts all over me. And by the way, I have absolutely zero remorse for killing any kind of bee that tries to sting me in the face. Even if I deserved it, no remorse. But anyways, that's kind of where things are at. Just continue to check for weight. Probably goes without saying that, if your bees are not proper weight, remember, like 80 pounds for singles, 100, 120 pounds for doubles. If they're not there, feed them as thick of a syrup as you can. Obviously with this, with us almost being in October, they're not going to have the time to evaporate and break down, extra moisture if you're giving them a 1-to-1 mix, even a 2-to-1 mix. So just give them a really good thick syrup. There's kind of a happy medium there, because obviously you don't want a syrup that's so thick that as soon as it gets a little cooler, it turns solid. But you do want one that's rather concentrated. So other than that, bees are looking really good. It's funny because I was actually talking to a few other colleagues of mine who are seeing the same thing, and it almost makes you paranoid because with strong bees comes also the opportunity for there to be large mite populations, because there's so many hosts for them. And so things can go sideways really quickly if you're not on top of them. That's why it's so important to just be really aggressive and be really proactive and seeing where your mite levels are, and then really focusing on nutrition. Nutrition is just so key. And which, by the way, I know I've mentioned this before, but when mixing your syrup, especially this time of year, if you put in 1 part per 100, which per gallon ends up being 2 tablespoons roughly, 2 tablespoons per gallon of apple cider vinegar, that helps clean the guts of the bees. It acts as a preventative as well for Nosema problems. It's not a silver bullet, but neither was the popular, was a fumagillin or whatever that I've seen now comes back or has come back. That's a whole topic in of itself, but apple cider vinegar works really well for that. And anyways, like I said, not much to say. That's it. Just want to do a little update. I hope your bees are looking good, and I'll catch you a little later. Bye. I thought I'd do one more quick video just discussing the plight of the beekeeper. in the sense of how keeping bees can be like having children, in the sense that, look at this. Look at this beautiful shirt I wore, and I'm the person, look at that, this brown spot. Think of all I do for the bees, and the way that they say thank you is by pooping on me. It really does feel like children, you know, just ungrateful. It's been a long day. I'm going to stop trying to be clever. Bye.